back porch of the house, the tear out has started. I've been working on it a couple hours, two or three times a week for a couple weeks now. But tear out has started. This was actually finished off quite nicely. It looked like that. He had all that plastic stuff up on the ceiling, so it looked brand new out here. This was all tile. There was a hot tub here. He's got the double vents up there. Lots of power. So it's a very capable little dog looking in the window. So I got sub panel here. But what's going to happen is that room in there is going to become our master bedroom on the first floor. We don't have a bedroom on the first floor at all, so we need one for as we get old. So there's going to be a door probably where this window is. I won't know for sure till I open up that wall and look at the structure. That used to be a doorway into the living room, but I closed that up when I remodeled the living room, and that's going to continue to be closed up. So what's going to happen is finish gutting this, rewire it, plumb it all out. This is going to be our master bath. This corner here, right there, is where that shovel is going to be a toilet. There's going to be a stub wall there. There's going to be a probably 32 by 60 shower right here to about here. And then here next to the shower is going to be another stub wall right there. And then in front of this system here, I'm going to put a 80-inch cabinet. I don't want to move that power box. There's just too much involved in moving that power box. I got to move the outlets and all that, the switches and stuff. That one, that lower outlet, that ran the power down there for the baseboard heater that was there. But that's got all got to be relocated. Okay, so we got an 80-inch cabinet there, and then the vanity will start, let's see, right about here. The vanity's going to start. It's going to be a 72-inch vanity come over to about here. And then over here, where the staging is, somewhere in this area, there's going to be a step-in tub. Obviously, all these windows have got to come out and be boarded up. There's five sets. They're triple window units each. And there's five sets of those. Those all have to come out. At the end of the tub, there's going to be another stub wall. It's going to come out almost... it's going to come out to like in this area here and go right over to that outside wall. And then in here is going to be a walk-in closet area, and then go through another stub wall over here. And then this is going to be our laundry right over in this area. So this is going to be a multi-year project, working on it, 4 or 5 months each spring, winter and spring, before riding season starts. And then, and multi thousands of dollars, of course. I looked at, priced out the cabinets. Just the cabinets are like $2,500. The shower unit's gonna be another $2,500. Tub, depending on which way we go, we're looking at somewhere between $500 and $2,000, depending on how fancy we go with the tub. Pretty sure we're gonna do a step in. We just finished talking about that. We were looking at an alcove type with tile around it for this corner, but we're thinking now we're going to do a step-in tub. So, I got a lot of, there's a cold water outlet right there. That was for the hot tub, but I got to run water all the way over here. I got to run a whole waste system, starting that corner for the toilet and then the sink or the shower and then the sinks, and then over around the corner into the, for the tub here. And then over there to the washing machine. The washing machine's probably going to be on the inboard side, dryer on the outboard side for the vent. And then tie it all in outside is where my main drain is. It comes down from the second floor. Comes in out there. Haven't decided exactly what we're doing with this door system yet. I'm pretty sure it's just going to go to a glass door. Do away with the screen door and just put a glass door in there. There's no need. This is going to be a heated and cooled space. I am concerned about the heating and cooling. I've got one big baseboard there on that wall. That's going to go away. The little one here is probably, I'm thinking, going to get mounted right there, because I'm not sure We're a long way from the HVAC unit. It's clear on the other side of the living room. So I'm concerned about how much the heating and cooling on this. Once these windows are all gone and it's all closed up and insulated, I'm hoping it's not terrible, but I'm actually thinking I might put a small window in this corner just so I can put in a small window air conditioning unit to supplement the big one. I got to cut holes in the floor and put ducting in and all that stuff for the big one. So that's what's keeping me busy.